Actually, we knew that we have a really good team, but for sure we didn't expect such a good tour. A really good atmosphere in the team, and I think that's it's also the reason why we have now such a good success.
Lyon, France, this finish of stage 14 right here in the city center. It's a lovely city center. Unfortunately, around the finish area, devoid of fans, as this is a red zone. Organizer have taken away the fans in this area, but we just heard from Mark Hershey. He said the reason they can win is because the spirit is so high after his win the other day. And of course, he says that they have many guys in the Sunweb team who are all at a high level. And so that helped paid off to see Soren Anderson come through here, the victor in stage 14.
Just want to get a feel for the battle between Bora and Quickstep. It looked like it was a real kind of mano a mano, team against team. What's the feeling there between the two teams?
It is, and we heard from Max Schachmann from Team Bora. He was, of course, up there in the final of yesterday's finish. And I said, you know, Max, you guys must have derived some pleasure out of putting Sam Bennett and the Kunik Quickstep in the hurt box today and putting Peter Sagan up there to get those points. He said, no. He said they were happy to drop Sam Bennett. That's the team's objective, but they're all friends in the peloton, and they don't like to see any guys suffering. We did see Peter Sagan zip down the hill in here to this finishing straight. Didn't win the group kick, got second in the group kit, third on the stage. So Sagan's kick isn't as it used to be, but he does have the legs to get over those climbs where guys like Sam Bennett doesn't. So I don't know the points right now, but the classification for the green jersey classification is getting closer and closer.
Gregor, I'm curious. You had a chat with the boys from Sunweb at the end of the stage there. And did you catch any wind that was part of the plan today, that this was something they'd cooked up in the bus? And obviously they have this great depth of and they're kind of the underdogs in a sense. We don't really hear much of those names. Obviously, Hershey has been incredible, but, Benoit and then Soren Craig pulling off this massive win. Did you feel that this was part of their plan today?
Yeah, and we had Matt Winston here in the mix zone, one of the directors at Team Sunweb, and he said even back during lockdown, they worked specifically with different groups of riders, targeting not only different races, but different phases in the races where they can use those guys. And we saw that, I think it was back in Paris-Nice, when Tiche Benoit pulled off that great stage win there with the help of his teammates. We saw Tiche Benoit heading out first on those two closing climbs, and then Mark Hershey followed by Soren Anderson for the victory, and your former teammate Swain, Luka Meskick there winning the sprint for the group behind. So really a orchestrated effort by Team Sunweb to pull off that victory for Soren Anderson. And we must note that this team is not one of the big winning teams, and it's been in a slump for a while to see these guys come through and in the biggest race of the year win two so far out of the 21 stages on offer as we're heading towards Paris.
Hey, Gregor, it looks like Hugo Houle had a problem, our only Canadian in the race. Tell us what happened with Hugo during the stage.
Yeah, interesting because, I'd forgotten about that. I saw it earlier on the coverage and I forgot all about him crashing. I did ask him at the start today to please stop at the finish because I thought he'd be up there in the mix today. He stopped and he said, oh, look, I crashed today. And he pointed down his left hip. He said it's nothing serious. And right as he was doing that, who rides up? Oliver Nason, and he's the guy who caused the crash. Oliver apologized on camera to FloBikes. He said he was tossing out a bottle, I think, if I recall right. That bottle got jammed in Hugo's spokes, and off Hugo went. Fortunately, he's good to fight another day, fighting for Miguel Angel Lopez in this 2020 Tour de France.
Well, thanks, Gregor. It's time for our guest host, Swain Tuft, and myself to get on with the analysis of the show. Thanks again.
Thanks, guys.